Hey, this is Flo, and in this video I will give you a few examples of how to use the new navigation stack that was introduced in SwiftUI 4 for iOS 16. And just a quick heads up, as of the date of this recording and until fall of 2022, all of this only works in the latest Xcode beta, so Xcode 14 beta 1 for me, so things might change as the summer goes on. If there is a breaking change, then I will leave a sticky comment down below, so have a look for the comment section for that. So you probably used to know the navigation view in SwiftUI and the navigation view style of stack. Now both of these have been deprecated as of iOS 16, and a few new views have been introduced instead, and also some new modifiers and overloads of existing views. One for the navigation stack and one for the navigation split view. In this video, we will cover the navigation stack with a few different examples, from the easiest example to a more advanced example with programmatic navigation, pop to root, and stuff like that. So let's get right into it. I have created an empty Xcode project. And first of all, let me create a model that we can use. And I will just call it content creator. And for the sake of this video, I will just copy a model that I already created beforehand. So we will need to import SwiftUI here. And this is just a simple struct that's identifiable, which is important because we will use a SwiftUI list. And it's hashable, which is actually needed for some of the new navigation APIs. Then it has an ID to be identifiable, a name, and then just a preview variable that we can use throughout our app. So first of all, let's get rid of this V stack and instead create a navigation stack. You can see there are a bunch of different initializers here. We will start with the simplest one, which is just a trailing closure for a view that is displayed inside of this navigation stack. And for that, we will create a list of content creators. So let's create a state variable to hold them. Let's call it content creators, which is of type array of content creator, and it's just our preview data that we defined in the other file here that I just copied over. Okay, now in the list, we can iterate over all of the content creators, grab one creator in here. Oops, the in keyword is missing, of course. And then now the first new thing we will have a look at in a second. So for now, let's just add a text of the creator.name. Let's actually remove that as here. Then you can see we basically have a simple SwiftUI list with all of our dummy data here. Now we want to add navigation links so the user could click onto, for example, Chris here, then a new view with details about him would show up. Just an example. So in the past, you used to create a navigation link here, and this is actually what you still do. But in the past, you had to provide a destination, which was a SwiftUI view. This is not the case anymore if you're using the new navigation stack. So instead, you can use this overload here with a title and a value, which is hashable. And this is actually the reason why we made our content creator struct here hashable as well. So as the title, this is basically just what's displayed in the list. So we will say creator.name, and then the value will be that creator of this current row. So now you can see we have our list here, and the user can't actually click on stuff here. And that's because we haven't specified what should be shown to the user when they click on one of these list items. So let's handle that next. For that, it's actually also super simple. There's a new modifier introduced, which is called navigation destination. There you always have to pass in a hashable type. So in our case, content creator.self. And then you get a trailing closure where you receive an instance of this type, and then you can return a view. So in this case, let's add a simple text view saying creator.name. And now if we actually click on these rows, it will navigate to a new screen. In our case, this is just a text view of the creator name because we specified that here in our navigation destination closure. And then there's of course also the back button available. So right now you could have done this super easily in SwiftUI 1.2.3 with a standard navigation view, but things are about to get a lot more interesting next up. So next, let's implement programmatic navigation, which is something that people have been wanting in SwiftUI forever, since it came out basically. And now we finally have it. So let me show you how it works. The navigation stack can have a path variable passed into it. Now, I don't really like the name path, but nevertheless, that's what it's called. So let's create a new state var and let's call it creator path. This will also be of type array of content creator, and in the beginning this will be empty. So this is basically our navigation stack. So maybe we should call it navigation stack, creator stack instead. And then in our navigation stack here, we can actually use one of these other initializers where we pass in a path, which is a binding to our creator stack. Now, you don't see any change because right now nothing actually did change, except for when the user clicks on the first row, then the item of that row, so this creator that is passed into the closure here, is actually put into this array of our creator stack. Logically speaking, if you remove an item from the array, it will get unnavigated, I would say. So in our navigation destination here, let's wrap this in a VStack and let's add a button beneath and let's say pop to root. And the method here is actually super simple. So let's just say creator stack is an empty array. So we reset the stack to show not a single creator. So if we click on Paul here and then say pop to root, the stack is empty. So nothing is shown except for this default content view here. Now this allows us to get a little bit crazy. So we could, for example, grab this entire list and put it inside of a VStack. And then below it, let's add another button. And let's say navigate 3 times. And this is actually how you would probably do deep linking in SwiftUI now. So let me copy over a snippet here just because it's easier. So with this snippet, I just set our, this is not what I called it. I called it creator stack. So with this snippet, I just set our creator stack to be 3 different creators. So what you would expect to happen is exactly what will happen. If we click this button, it will navigate 1, 2, 3 times, and we can go back 1, 2, 3 times. So let's hit navigate 3 times. Right now, not much happening, but if we hit back, we go back to Paul, back, we go back to Chris, back, we're back in our home screen. And of course now Chris was content creators 0, Paul was content creators 1, and Vincent was content creators 2. Now this works, of course, because we specified our navigation destination for the content creator type. Since we have this modifier now, we can actually chain these for different types of content. So for that, let me copy over another model, which I called framework. And this is just a single enum with a few different frameworks that you might already know. So SwiftUI, UIKit, AppKit, and WatchKit. I've made it a string as its raw type, so we have something to show to the user. I made it hashable, of course, because that's what our navigation destination needs from our types. And I made it case iterable, so we can iterate over it in our list. Now let's actually get rid of the navigation stack here. And also this navigate 3 times button, and also this pop to root button. So we can make this a little bit simpler. And then instead of our list, let's have a for each. I'm just changing around the architecture here a bit. And let's put that for each into a section called content creators in our list, just like that. Now we can add a second section for our frameworks. So let's add that. Oops. And in here, let's create a new state variable for our frameworks, which is of type framework, and it's framework.allCases. So here we can now say for each of our frameworks, with an identifier of self, because it's not identifiable, it's just hashable. Let's grab that framework in. And let's have another navigation link, this new one with the value. So as a title, let's say framework.rowValue. This is why we made it a string. And then the value is just that framework itself. Now what you will see is we can click on the content creators and it will navigate, but it will not navigate if we click on the frameworks, because we only specified a navigation destination for the type content creator. So let's create a second navigation destination for the type of framework.self. And this will of course give us a framework, and in here we can add a text of framework.rawValue. And now if we click on UIKit, it will actually navigate to a text view saying UIKit. Then of course we can go back, click on Chris, and so on and so on and so on. Now I think this really gave SwiftUI so many superpowers with respect to the navigation stack, and there's even more with the navigation split view, which is not covered in this video once again. I will probably make a separate video on that. In this video, you hopefully learned how the new navigation stack works, that it has replaced the old navigation view style of .stack, how you can programmatically navigate to different screens, how you can pop to root, and how you can specify navigation destinations based on the type of thing that is passed into the navigation link. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to subscribe to not miss any of the other WWDC content that will be out soon. And with that said, I will see you in the next one. Bye.